Welcome, welcome, welcome to new SafeShares Dev Podcast. It's been a while that I gave you an update on different development podcasts on SafeShares and different developments I did. And this time around, I want to make it a bit shorter because the other videos are so long and only for a niche that interesting. But if you're starting development, maybe you want to short, comprehensive talk about developing. So, development, I added something new, so you don't see me coding here. No, I coded already, and what you can see right now is the remorse item that I misused a bit to make a nice little effect. And what I want to show you is the effect first, therefore I will start up my virtual machine here to show you how this will look like in SafeShares OS when it's running. Takes a while to start. Let's hit play and then we'll see. I think it started up. Yeah. Just a few seconds. It will build and then I can show you the effect of my web browser. Then because we want to do something in our web browser. And I want to show you how you can use remorse items in SafeShares and how you can do some useful things. And in this case, is it really useful? I have to say I just simply ripped off what Firefox offers already, or various different other browsers offer already. Just like a little thing that if you start your web browser and you click on a link, hold longer and open a new tab, and it opens in the background, that it offers you a simple remorse item at the bottom that says switch. You opened a new tab. Do you want to switch? And then you can just click on switch to go to the new tab. So very convenient feature. And yeah, this you can do with a remorse item. I'm not sure why it takes so long to build stuff. Yola, you have to improve this. This is like super, super crazy long. Anyway. The remorse item. Let's talk about the remorse item. Remorse item on SafeShares. There's a documentation for it available, and allows you to do very certain things like a slider basically running 5 seconds by default, and after it ran for 5 seconds, it will automatically then perform an action. And in this case, you have some options here that you can tweak and change. Just like, for example, you have the option to set a cancel text. So if you want to, because every remorse timer is usually doing for, there's something destructively that I'm doing right now, and after the timer runs out, there will delete a file, for example. And then you have a cancel text to cancel this. And what I do here in this case is I want to have such a timer running, but it's not really canceling something out. When I click on it, I want to switch to the new tab that I created. And by the way, it's still not building. It's in deployment. It's running. So let's go to Yola users, for example. This website, is it still available, this website? Hope so. You better be available. So that's your users website. Okay. Okay. Cookies. I love cookies. Necessary. Always enabled. Huh? That's a weird rendering. By the way, Yola, you have to really get rid of this old cute WebKit. It's like super, super odd in this behavior. I cannot click OK here. Anyway. If you have the same issue, by the way, install my Qt WebKit 5.212 version, otherwise you get crazy. So if I have now this here, I can click on it longer. No, I cannot. Let's do this on another website. Yola Together is a pretty simple, easy website. This should work without any issue. Let's hope. And wow. Anyway, So I have a link right here now. I want to open it in the background. I can press and hold and say open a new tab. And what will happen now is there will be a new tab opened and switch. And if I click on it, it would switch to the new tab. This is now, of course, an old style of doing things. There's a new style in CephHS 3.2.1.20, which places a switch text here as a button to click. And I think this is more than conform with what can be seen on Firefox on Android, for example. So what this allows me to do is just simply switch to this tab. Let me demonstrate how it works again. Again, holding here, open new tab, and then if I click here, boom, it switches directly to this tab, which is a nice thing to do. By the way, you can also double click here to switch, or double tap here to switch between tabs, between the two last tabs that you use. Anyway, remorse new tab is the remorse item that I created. I changed the cancel text from cancel or abort to switch, because I want to switch. I can use also a translation here for this. And I give it an action, switch to tab. Switch to tab is a function that I have written, which is here. Switch to tab, there we have it, which takes a page ID, and then it does the magic to switch to this tab. So this is old, I don't have to show you this. So on canceled, because the text is not canceled, if you click on it, it will cancel stuff. And on cancel, it will just switch to tab. Yeah, what do I need to do to make it run is just simply go to open a new tab and edit this one. And what I did is here, first of all, I have to set a new tab because you saw it takes a page ID. And I generate this page ID here with a new tab, page salt. So it uses the name page and then a salt to create a new tab. So every tab is unique in a way. And I use this to basically create the new tab and open it in the background already. And then I'll show the remorse timer and I set the new tab variable for the remorse timer, which is here, property var new tab. I set it up to be the new tab here so that I really get the right tab. And then I execute the remorse new tab using a helper remorse. I had to do a helper remorse because I want to show it above the remorse timer or remorse items work that they have to have some kind of parent where they show themselves. And as I don't want to show it directly over the completely web view, otherwise it would be showing really over the complete web view, and I don't want to show it on top of my panel. So I don't want to show it here completely, and I don't want to show it here completely on the panel. I want to show it above the panel. I have to create a little rectangle that I did here, which is a helper remorse rectangle, which is has a toolbar height, so it's the same height as the toolbar itself. It has the parent width, and color is transparent, so no one can see it by default, and the bottoms anchors bottom to the toolbar top. So pretty easy, and then I say when I execute my remorse new tab that I want to have this invisible kind of thing as my parent, and then I give it of course an text which is also translatable, new tab opened. I think this is the same terminology Firefox uses, so it should be understand. And then I have a function here, and this function is empty. Why is it function empty? Because after 5 seconds it wants to do something, wants to execute something, and this is my function that it wants to execute. In this case, the function does nothing, because that's what it should do. It should do nothing if the timer runs out. So this is a little hack to tweak the remorse item to work like I want it to work. That's everything for this little development screencast. I hope you understood everything, and if you have questions, you can ask me in the comments section, and check out all the other videos that I did, even if they're a bit longer. And enjoy, thumbs up, and all this shit. And until the next time, bye.